I will send a good morning to you all again. May the peace of God continually be with you. I would like to say a big thank you to Reverend Herbert Aparanda, the speaker of this church, for allowing us to use this wonderful business. I want to thank you all for coming. I know when you look around, you'll start thinking what all the people around you are thinking. You will think and ask questions that can be answered by you. But if you were there yesterday, we had the direction. The direction was the kind of person this woman is. We've heard about the gift of God upon our life to evangelize to people. We've seen and heard how a mother they came forward and look, how they came forward to share the word about us. The Bible says a good, a great person leads in everything for their children, and not just to them, but to their children. She has left an inheritance. Inheritance is not your wealth. It's not the houses that you purchase. It's not the car that you drive, but something that will last and make you at peace with God. We thank God for the lighting. And oftentimes I tell people, when you write somebody's name, you write from to. And the Bible says in Ecclesiastes 3:20, it says, from dust. Welcome to dust, O Lord. The beginning of man is dust. The end of man is dust. But there is a dash in between. When they write your name, after you have reached good old age and you pass on, there will be from to that time. That too is what I want you to think about today. From the time you were born till now, there's a gap. And that gap must be filled by everyone. The way you fill the gap is how we talk about it now. But more important is not what people say about you now, it's what everyone says about you. The only thing this woman would have wished today is for you to have a look at your life and say, how have I lived my life? You know what the good news is? There is still time. There is still time. And I want to ponder. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes 7, from verse 2-4, it says, better to go to the house of God, where they are sold. It says, it's better for a man to go there than to go to the house of Christ. For that is the end of all men. And the living will take it to heart. Thank God. He says, sorrow is better than laughter. The heart of the wise is in the house of mourning, but the heart of fools is in the house of enjoyment. We are all here today because the Bible says, when we come to a gathering like this, it ministers to us. It keeps us in check. It makes us think about our life. How are we living my life? How are we living your life? Chickens, yes. Like one of the children are thinking. that it's better to let people know how you feel while they're alive.
Yes.
If you have merited the blessings, your spouses, your children, appreciate them. When they are gone, they can be able to. Who are you appreciating today? Life is so short. There is no need to act. There is no need to fret. There is no need for enmity with anything. Everything you acquire now, you will live on earth. Hallelujah. The Bible says in Matthew, thou be my name, sweet God. In Matthew 22, from verse 1 to 14, he says, and Jesus answered and spoke to them again by parables and said, the kingdom of heaven is like a certain king who arranged a marriage for his son and sent out his servants, all those who were invited to the wedding, and who were not willing to come. We had testimonies yesterday. There were invitations. The lightning became an invitation. He said, he sent the servants out to get people to come to the feast. But they refused. And the Bible goes on to say, again, he sent all the servants. If you have given your head to the word of God so many times, and still you have not made the decision yet to be right with him and follow him, now is the time for it. He says, he sent the servants again to tell them. At the same time, look at this man. Every vein was open, but yet he refused to wear the right apron. He sat there for so long. We are still sitting. We are still living. We can change it now. What do I say? You can change it now. May the Lord answer. Why did the king reject this man? The king rejected the man because he is the king. Because you have a great free invitation doesn't mean you should give it up or you should wear anything. The king has the power, like God has. He has the power to do it. He's the one that makes the one that calls for himself. We will ask questions about this word of God. But God has taken part of it. Everything he has done is left behind. You will not take anything new except for me. Hallelujah. The Bible says, do not be afraid of those who kill the Lord, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the Lord that can destroy both the soul and the body. Let's be afraid of God. Everyone of us are so busy being scared of men that we have forgotten who God is. He is the Almighty. He is the everlasting God. In him we live, in him we move, in him we have our everything. The Lord will comfort you. There are any obstacles there. But you know the good news as well. He says, come unto me. Those that are bring every burden to him this morning. He will give you rest. May the Lord bless us.
Amen.
You know the Bible says in the book of Genesis, it was talking about Rachel. He said, and the Lord remembered Rachel and opened her womb. You are the violence of the Lord. The Lord will open the womb of patience.
Amen.
And the womb of Jesus. And all of you will stand up.
Amen.
You will have strength.
Amen.
The peace of God will reign.
Amen.
You will not die before your
children.
You will see your children's children.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When you look back at today, you will give glory to God.
Amen.
You shall not be found in
the
name of Jesus. The Lord will give you utterance.
Amen.
What you say with your mouth will not be a curse unto you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As the church will build the wall of protection around you. By the word of the Lord. No evil will come to
you.
In the name of Jesus. And all the family and friends, the same prayer goes to you. The peace of God will be upon you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
John 4 says from verse 3, for the hour is coming, and now that time when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father is seeking those that will worship Him in spirit and in truth. Check your life. I keep saying that is what the environment is that has not been made by men, but has been made by heaven. The one thing He will give people food to bring them to Christ. Amen. Before she left, she said, let us share with us. I was there till the last minute. And the brother, the Lord bless you. That man left everything. He put everything on hold for 2 days. He got a call and he responded. But she will not die before his name. God in the world.
Amen.
She, even take down couples dinner. I remember when she was leaving and we were talking to her. And she talked to my wife. She said, my 50th, I'm not doing it here. She said, I'm doing it in Jerusalem. When she said that, nothing to be interpreted. On Sunday, when we go to the hospital, when she saw us again, she repeated it. My pastor, I am not doing my 50th year. I'm doing it in Jerusalem. You know what? She fulfilled that. What is not known to us is known to God. There is no, it's not the time. We must not mourn the people without hope. Let us put our hope and trust in the Lord will bless us. She came to church, I think, 2 Sundays before, and the message that preached was, God is still God. She went on her Facebook, if you go there, then you still see. She put it there, God is still God. And she looked at me and said, Pastor, God is still God. In spite of everything, God. Even though she died at 49,
God is still God.
Even though she left her children behind, which is the prayer of every woman,
God is still God.
Even though she could not do some things in pen on her diary until the end of the year, God
is still God.
God is still God. That answers your question. She left the answer because of that. All on her pain. I will just finish now with this story that I have. And I will just share that story with us. He says that there was a king was upon a time. This king, a very rich king, had 4 wives. And he loved the 4th wife very much. Would give a gift, rich robes. Treated her to the finest of dedications. He gave her nothing but the best. That's the fourth one. The third one, he did very much so for her. Was always showing this third one off to neighbors, to neighboring countries. He would go and show her, and he feared that one day, this wife will leave for another man. The second wife, because he's confident, they say, came together, very kind, considerate, and patient with him. Whenever the king faced a problem, he will confide in the second wife. And she will help him get through the difficult times. The first one was very loyal, made great contributions in maintaining his wealth, his kingdom. However, he did not love her. Although she loved him deeply, he had little thoughts of her. One day, this king was very ill. He knew his time was short. He called on his wife. He had the father. He told the father, I love you most. And now you were the finest clothing and shall I take care of you. Now that I'm dying, will you follow me and keep my company? The wife replied, no way. She walked away without another word. Her answer caught him like a shot, pierced through his heart, and yet he had to call the other one. So he called the third one. He said, I've loved you all my life. Now that I'm dying, will you follow me and keep my company? No, the third one said, life is too good. When you die, I'm going to remember. of man is as God. No matter how much time and effort we lavish in making it look good, it will leave us when we die. The third one is our possessions. Your status, your wealth, when you die, it goes to others. It remains. Most of us have got property to somebody only before.
Yes.
Our possessions will go to other people, whether they are our people, children, or other people. The second one, they are family or friends. They can only go without a degree. Sad. Like everyone else. When we get there, what do we do? The first one, your soul, it goes with you. Please look at your soul right now. Are you feeding your soul with what you read about? If you have not made it right with the Lord, I want you to think about that right now. Let all heads bow, all eyes close. If you want the Lord to minister to you right now, and you want to give your life to him, which Maria Kikelomo would have loved you to. Just raise your hand up and pray. If you think, Lord, I've lived a life that I need you to reveal me, minister right, I've drifted away from you. I've placed all that I can on material things. I looked after my possession. I looked after my body. I looked after every other thing except my soul. Now is the time for you to align yourself with God. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for this great work that you have done through the world. Lord, we have come together today, not just because we have come to bury him today, but we have come to give life to the living. Lord, let everyone here receive life in abundance. In the name of Jesus, let your peace saturate our hearts. Let every trouble, let your peace minister to them. Lord, we pray. None of us shall miss heaven. In the name of Jesus, may the peace and the grace of God be upon you. And the Lord will interpret in a greater dimension the word of God. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, so shall it be. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Now, what happened to the today? Oh, Father, there is nothing we can give them that will be better than that. If you give them money, you spend. But when you pray, it goes and beyond. So I want the family to rise up and come to you. Many staff of the house are always enjoying. I can see some. Please join me, the pastors there. John, let's declare the peace of God upon this family, this wonderful family. That the grace of God will abound in your heart. That the joy of the Lord will be your strength. Let's just stretch forth our hands. Let the ministers, let's come down. Let's come down. Let's come down. Let's give you the ring of fire down. Let's come 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 down. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, let's come down. Let your praise be upon. Let's take care of peace. The joy of the Lord. Begin to be upon us. Peace and passing even on the steps. The Lord will protect them, holding up on their property. The Lord will wipe away their sins. All your joy is spirit of business.
solid rock my strength.
Otherwise, I need a
We can't even come here. You know, we have shown, you know, so wonderful. We thank them. We thank a lot of people. You know, I don't even know. I don't know most of our names. Most important thing again, you know, I have to thank Barbara Labai, you know, my wife, our dear mother, you know, for their support. We thank Reverend Olabayo Bennett for his support. We thank Pastor Sade yesterday. A lot of people, Pastor Love, with a lot of people, ministers of God, you know, all friends and family, we give glory to God. The last but not the least, Brother Shepherd, I don't know your surname, the guy that we by the bedside. You know, who for 8 hours a day was there. He took his time and the Lord bless you, the Lord will keep you. Send the pain and not even come to the way in the name of Jesus. The glory of God will shine upon you in the name of Jesus. Upon the children of God, nobody was there.
Okay, guys, thank you, everybody. So that is that for the church and service. So we're going to be proceeding now to the burial ground where the body will be laid to rest finally. So thank you, everybody, for joining us. We have to have the church program here now as we proceed to the burial ground where the body will be finally laid to rest. So thank you, everyone. Thank you, guys. We're waiting for the family to come out now. So So thank you, everyone. We've exhausted the battery of this particular phone, so I have to swap the phone now so we can cover the cemetery event. So thanks, everyone, and I'll see you guys in about another 20 minutes. Thank you, everyone. Bye bye.